Thank you. you'll hear about the progress of the previous year, meet your outgoing and incoming board members and 2020 officers, see what's new in attractions all over the world, be massively inspired by your IAPA Hall of Fame inductees, and so much more. In roughly 1 hour, we'll walk you to the expo floor. And now, a few words from the Executive Director and Vice President of IAPA's Europe, Middle East, and African region, Jacob Wall.
Moin. Es ist schön, so viele von Ihnen hier in Orlando begrüßen zu dürfen. Einige von Ihnen habe ich auch bereits in Paris gesehen. Wie Sie vielleicht wissen, hat die IAPA weltweit 6.000 Mitglieder. 25% davon kommen alleine aus der EMEA-Region, tatsächlich aus 57 Ländern. Die Aufgabe unseres Teams in Brüssel ist es, Ihnen das gesamte Jahr über, nicht nur hier auf den Veranstaltungen, mit Rat und Tat zur Seite zu stehen. Dafür können Sie uns jederzeit kontaktieren, per Telefon, E-Mail, WhatsApp, was auch immer. Wir sprechen dafür auch 9 verschiedene Sprachen. Deutsch, Englisch, Französisch, Italienisch, Holländisch, Spanisch, Portugiesisch, Rumänisch, Russisch. Also insofern suchen Sie sich was aus, melden Sie sich bei uns und machen Sie diesen Verband auch zu Ihrem Verband. Und jetzt wünsche ich Ihnen viel Spaß in Orlando.
We've all seen that person. You know the one. They won't sit down, no matter how close it is to showtime. Maybe that's you. Maybe you're in a corner checking emails right now. But it's time to sit down. Seriously. Sit down. This is it. We're officially 1 minute to showtime. At the risk of being a little repetitive, time to take a seat and silence your phone. We sincerely hope you enjoy the show.
welcome to IAAPA Expo 2019, the global attractions industry's premier event.
The IAAPA Expo is incredibly impressive. The wide range of different things you can do and learn about.
Ito'y dahil marami akong natututunan, marami akong nakikilala.
La novedad, la cantidad de gente, la energía, los colores, todo lo que pasa en el trade show floor.
Un evento rodeado de charlas, de conferencias, de buenos amigos, de relacionamiento.
Onde a gente faz muito networking com os melhores da indústria e desenvolvemos muito nosso conhecimento.
Essa oportunidade de aprendizado, de relacionamento e de contatos é imperdível.
I love the diversity at this expo and just being able to talk to all kinds of people is so exciting.
A Expo IAAPA é pura vida.
Hosted by the association that brings the industry to life for its members.
My favorite part of IAAPA is access to the thousands of educational opportunities involved with the association.
Por causa da oportunidade que tenho de trabalhar com os colegas do mundo inteiro e aprender com todos vocês.
All the relationships that I've made over the years and the impact those people have had on me.
Compartir nuestras experiencias con otros parques del mundo.
My favorite part of being a member of IAAPA is having a network of colleagues.
وآخر شيء ودي أقوله أن من خلال IAAPA عندي عائلة ثانية من جميع أنحاء العالم.
Um abração, pessoal.
Different jobs. We live and work in different countries. We even represent different constituencies. IAAPA connects us all. When we come together, it creates a burst. Jonathan Lee Iverson, the last ringmaster for the iconic American attraction, Ringling Brothers and Barnum and Bailey, the greatest show on earth. Oh, I love you already. We're gonna have some fun. This is good. This is the week where we come together as industry professionals to compare notes. Meetings here catalyze change, create partnerships, and inspire innovation. In the next hour, we'll hear crucial updates. IAPA is global and our industry moves fast, so it's easy to miss details. Today, we'll get caught up together. It's gonna go fast and then we'll make our way to the expo floor. This kickoff event grows and changes every year. We have about 500 of our friends and colleagues in a room across the hall. So everybody say hello!
Hello.
Plus, we're live streaming this morning, and this event is also going out to members around the world. So a big shout out to all of IAPA that's with us in this morning, but not in the room. Let's say hello to them as well. Now, I want you all to take another look at this screen. You may have spotted a difference in our look, and it has a deeper meaning. As you could see in the opening number, we believe we're many members made stronger by our diversity. Now, I was speaking to our CEO, Hal McAvoy, last night, and I'm paraphrasing here, but he said, "We've always believed that, but between the logo and the show today, we're gonna make sure people know what we believe." So let's hear from the man himself. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome President and CEO, Hal McAvoy.
Jonathan, thank you so much.
And welcome, welcome.
Thank you, thank you. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
God, the energy in here is just amazing. Thank you for being here. You've traveled to Orlando from all over the globe, demonstrating your commitment to growing your business and growing your careers. For me, this week is a bit of a reunion, a time to connect with old friends, meet new professional colleagues. IAPA is incredibly strong, and we need to be, because together we serve over 1 billion people. Those people keep us united by purpose like no other organization that I know of. You create memories. You create magic. You stimulate economies, and you provide jobs. We are lucky to work in a field that's all about making people happy and creating opportunities. IAPA is here to support you as you all do that important work around the world. In addition to the expo this week, I hope you learn as much as possible about how IAPA can serve you. For example, while you're in Orlando this week, we'd love for you to visit the brand new headquarters. It's your home. We're actually offering guided tours throughout the week. Stop by IAPA Central for more tour information. How many of you have done the tour already? Hands up. What do you think? It's amazing. And that building is designed by members for members. Another way you'll learn is through the 2019 IAPA chairman, David Rosenberg, who will be up here in just a bit to cover what a huge year this has been. In the week ahead, you'll enjoy many, many opportunities to network with even more of your peers. As always, we'll talk best practices, solutions, insights into all facets of our work. Inspiration will be everywhere. This week is all about what's new, what's now, and what's next.
Wonderfully said, Hal. You know, so many people work hard to make this week happen. This IAPA Expo kickoff event is made possible by the generous support of our sponsors. First, we would like to thank the Wanda Group, sponsor of the IAPA Theater. Established in 1988, Wanda Group has become a large multinational conglomerate focusing on modern services. After 30 years of development, Wanda is now one of the world's leading real estate, film, sports, and children's entertainment companies.
Wow. We'd also like to extend our thanks to Amico, platinum sponsor of today's kickoff event.
This is Amico Resort Destination Theme Park, centrally located on the Riviera Maya in Mexico. The company celebrates the Maya's deep heritage and culture through history, education, a world-class museum, and of course, a theme park experience. The resort showcases the cultural, natural, historical, and recreational wealth of Mexico to the world.
Ambrogen Technologies Incorporated, platinum sponsor of today's kickoff event.
A leading supplier of flying theater solutions, Ambrogen Technologies has recently launched MRIDE, a brand new type of flying theater. The 180-degree turning seats deliver a new kind of reveal and a spectacular flight experience. The very first installation of MRIDE opened in March this year as a signature attraction at Legoland. MRIDE is one of the world's best, most compact, high-capacity solutions for theme parks and tourist attractions.
And thank you to the gold sponsors of the kickoff event, Attraction and Entertainment Solution, and Dippin' Dots.
And finally, thank you to the silver sponsors of the kickoff event, Jack Rouse Associates, and Price Tag. All right, my friends, that's a wrap for our friend Hal McAvoy. How about it, ladies and gentlemen?
Jonathan, thank you so much.
Thank you again, everyone. Enjoy the show.
We stand on the shoulders of giants in this industry. They're all around you right now. Without them, we wouldn't be here today. They mentor and inspire us. They motivate us. They catch us through the ups and downs over the years. The IAPA Hall of Fame was established in 1990 to celebrate these individuals' outstanding achievements and significant contributions to the global attractions industry. The innovative ideas and approaches created and implemented by these individuals have inspired success and fueled the growth and development of the industry. An industry like few others depends on the imagination, talent, vision, and leadership of these dream builders. Since that time, dozens of industry pioneers and legends have received this prestigious honor. In fact, before we begin, we want to acknowledge the IAPA Hall of Fame members present in the room today. So please stand that we may honor you properly. Stand, don't be shy, stand. You're Hall of Famers. Thank you so much. You may be seated. Now it's time to induct two additional visionaries into the IAPA Hall of Fame. To help us do that, please welcome to the stage Chairman of the IAPA Hall of Fame and Archives Committee, Mr. Michael Collins.
Thanks, Jonathan.
I love your suit.
Thank you. I do own one. Thank you, Jonathan. This year we wanted to showcase our Hall of Fame so you can really see the impact these members have made.
Just think about how much has been accomplished. Innovations, big ideas, and technology that changed the game.
You'll see recognizable and beloved attractions.
You'll see people who added their style to our industry in such a way that it became the new standard.
Let's meet our first new inductee.
Fred Langford is an architect, inventor, designer, and dreamer. and is considered by many to be the father of the modern water slide. His work is recognized throughout the industry as the gold standard for design and fabrication of water slides. He holds multiple patents and was one of the first to use fiberglass, which quickly replaced the concrete water slides of the past. His innovations are the foundation of the elevated water slides produced in water parks around the world today. His design allowed for the flume to be a self-supporting beam, which created longer spans between columns and hence allowed for more design creativity. He saw the water slide and water parks as a social space requiring spectators to be part of the show, which led to the elevated walkways and spectator platforms that are nearly universal today. Fred Langford, you added an artistic flair to slide design. A leader of one of the world's top water slide companies said, "Fred made us all better."
IARPA is proud to bestow its most prestigious honor and welcome you to the Hall of Fame. Please welcome to the stage Fred Langford. Congratulations, Fred. Congratulations.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I guess I've had the normal share of compliments in my lifetime, but nothing compares with the awesome Hall of Fame Award. I also have to thank my four wonderful children, Jill, Mark, Lana, and Lynn, for their unwavering love and devotion through my career, a career which kept me away from home for many days and many weeks. I also want to thank the park owners and their managers who accepted my water slides and gave me a lot of freedom with my designs. And special thanks to those owners who allowed me to return and build a second or third ride. The team, my little team, produced water slides for 72 locations over a period of 29 years. I'm thankful and proud of their diligent and dedicated effort. I'm also extremely proud of the fact that we were invited to return to 42 of those locations to add more slides. The slide layouts start with freehand sketches, which I like to think will develop into beautiful sculptural entries. That's me, I'm always reading. In fact, there's a picture in my ninth grade yearbook under the name Fred Langford. It says Dreamer. They had me down as a dreamer then. Water slides are made of sections we call flumes. Is everyone ready for water slide 101? The flume parts are made from molds. The shape and precision of the molds is paramount to the eventual statement. I'm indebted to the cabinet-making carpentry skills of those who produced those molds, Bill Guldner and my son, Mark Langford. It goes without saying that structural integrity is of extreme importance, as well as surface beauty and the fabrication of flume parts. I have to give credit to the fiberglass companies Raised Plastic in New Jersey and Canbar Products in Canada for their well-built, beautiful product. The same structural integrity requirements holds true for the fabrication of the steel towers. And the flume supports my thanks to Martin Steel of New Jersey and Seguin Fabrication of Texas for their contribution of precision products. The erection process is an art in itself, with cranes, scaffolding, and man lifts. Three men sent out who supervised the erection crews that put together on site the hundreds of flume sections and steel parts. They were Lou Camerata, Bob Leitz, and my brother, Gus Langford. Special thanks because they were so special, my lovely daughters who kept us all organized, Lana O'Neill and Lynn Langford.
Wonderful.
Thank you so much, Fred Langford. Everybody, thank you so much to our wonderful Hall of Fame inductee.
Thank you, Fred.
The wonderful Mr. Fred Langford.
Thank you.
concepts and my dreams by a man who was a loyal friend from the time we were together in Wildwood High School and through my business life. That man was Will Morey Sr. My journey to the stage here at IAAP started 42 years ago. It was 1997 and Will Morey called me with a message, Fred, I just got back from the IAAP show and I bought something that I think is terrific. I bought a water slide. At that point in time, I must admit that my knowledge of water slides was limited to something 6 or 8 feet tall next to a pool. Will then explained that each of the slide complexes were 40 feet tall and 100 feet in length, 300 feet in length, and he needed my help to build stair towers and wood trestle support structures. The rest is history. And so,
we better wrap it up. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
I liked it. Congratulations. Thank you so much.
Let's hear it again for the legendary Fred Langford. Mike, I'll never look at a water slide the same again.
Absolutely. It's complex business.
Now it's time to meet our second inductee. The name Zamperla can be found in almost every park around the world, from Disneyland Paris to local FECs with rides like the Rocking Tug, Disco, Air Race, and Magic Bikes. That's Magic Bikes, ladies. That have become classics. When Alberto Zamperla took over the family business in 1994, the Zamperla company grew from producing 50 rides per year to more than 200. With production facilities in Italy, China, and Belarus, the Zamperla company is now one of the largest ride manufacturers in the world. Alberto worked hard to bring international manufacturing standards to their facility in China. In addition, he dramatically improved rider accessibility, as was demonstrated by his contribution to Give Kids the World, Laurie's Magical Flight, which was the first attraction there to offer children with disabilities a truly authentic ride experience. Under his leadership, Zamperla also designed rides for kids and their parents to enjoy together. He was the founder and first chairman of the European Suppliers Association, EASI, the organization that created the Euro Attraction Show, which is now IAAPA Expo Europe.
For your innovation and tireless dedication to the growth of the amusement park and attractions industry, IAAPA is proud to bestow its most prestigious honor and welcome you to the Hall of Fame. Please welcome to the stage Alberto Zamperla. Congratulations, Alberto.
Good morning, everybody, and thank you for being here today. I am pleased and honored to receive this important award in the presence of so many leaders and colleagues. I am also happy to join the past recipients who I deeply admire and respect. First of all, I would like to thank IAAPA, its organization, and its people. A round of applause for the people from the IAAPA. Without them, we have... Thank you. We are now a successful company. When you will go to the show, you will see a big Zamperla booth. There are in Orlando more than 60 Zamperla people that are going to attend to the seminar and to the show. But our success story started 40 years ago when I drove a pickup truck pulling a mini jet with my wife Paola from Montreal, where we have our first office in North America, to Atlanta to attend to the IAAPA show. So, a long story. My sincere thanks also go to the who mentioned me on those who support my nominations. to my whole family, my wife Paola, and my sons. My employee for always putting up with me and being such an incredible group of valuable, dedicated, and passionate people. To all Zamperla customers too, who have believed in us and motivated us to work harder to give them the best product and service. This award celebrates my contribution to our industry and business, and is another important milestone of the Zamperla history. And now, with my son, we will write the next chapter. Thank you again for your consideration. Thank you.
The important bit. Congratulations.
Congratulations, sir.
Once again, let's hear it for the legendary Alberto Zamperla. And ladies and gentlemen, join me in thanking Michael Collins and his fantastic committee for all their hard work in honoring history. Let's hear it for Michael Collins.
Thank you, Jonathan.
Every day, we do the gentle dance of running our attractions. We all have a reason. Some of us are in the family business, maybe. We're recreating happy memories from childhood, but all of us know a little something about happiness that inspires hope, especially our next presenter. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome President and CEO of Give the Kids the World, Pamela Lanworth.
What a wonderful introduction.
Thank you.
Good morning. What a thrill it is to be back on the IAPA stage, surrounded by so many treasured friends who share a passion for our mission and a desire to make a difference in the lives of the precious children we serve. This year, we're celebrating the 25th anniversary of our amazing partnership with IAPA, and so many incredible things have happened during that 25 years. You know, it's such a blessing to be part of an industry where people have such huge hearts and they show it day in and day out. It's just absolutely amazing. You know, I've often shared with you that I think we have similar missions. You know, your desire is to create that perfect guest experience for your guests so that they'll keep coming back year after year. Well, we need to create that perfect guest experience for our precious guests because they can't come back. We only get one chance to do it right. We don't have any do-overs. But thanks to the World Passport for Kids program, our families are able to extend the magic of that wish for a year. They can visit any participating theme park around the world. That gives them the opportunity to create new memories, which will hopefully inspire them to go back and continue their battle against their illness, or maybe celebrate that at the end of the treatment, or perhaps some wonderful memories that provide a source of strength and comfort when they chase, you know, when they face even more challenging times. But I think the World Passport does even more than we actually ever intended. I received a letter from a wish-granting organization at the end, actually, of that IAPA Expo last year, and I've been carrying it around because I wanted to share it with you today. It's about a little girl named Bryn, and it came from the wish-granting partner. Said, Bryn visited Give Kids the World in June 2018 and spent her fourth birthday at the village. 3 weeks ago, which would have been the end of October of last year, she and her family planned a spur-of-the-moment trip to Sesame Place. They left Friday night, so they'd be there first thing in the morning and had a great day despite the rain. On Sunday, Bryn was lethargic and was throwing up with no fever. This was a sign that her brain cancer, anaplastic lymphoma, may have come back despite having received a clean MRI 3 weeks prior. They took her to CHOP, which is the Children's Hospital of Pennsylvania. And luckily, the doctor on call was an expert in her particular tumor, which is extremely rare because there are less than 200 cases diagnosed a year. Bryn had a very successful surgery and got a clean report from her lumbar puncture. Unfortunately, she has a long and uncertain road ahead, but thanks to Give Kids the World and a desire to go to Sesame Place, her family feels that they were blessed to have been near CHOP and that particular surgeon. What an incredible story. And I had the wonderful blessing of meeting Bryn and her family when we did our Coasting for Kids event at Sesame Place this summer. And her mom sat down and shared with me that she truly believes that the outcome would have been much different if she had not had the ability, because they didn't have the financial means to go to Sesame Place on their own. But it was because they had the world passport and they were able to do it at the spur of the moment that they were able to be next to a hospital where a doctor was there on call at the moment they needed her most. And Bryn is just one of 173,000 families that we've been able to serve since we opened our doors in 1986. And that sounds like a staggering number, but there's about 30,000 children diagnosed every year with a life-threatening illness. And we know that half of them, when they express their wish, it's to come be part of us. We try to create a brand new story for those families while they're with us for that one precious week. And it's because of you that we're able to do it. You know, every story starts with once upon a time. And our once upon a time begins with everyone in this room who shares your heart in so many incredible ways by your fundraising, by your in-kind donations, by supporting all of the events that we do through IAPA, the Expo, and around the world, through your support of our Coasting for Kids and the World Passport Program. You know, we don't know the fate of every single child that leaves the village. We wish that every single story that's been told would have a happy ending. But we're also realists, and we know that many of the stories don't have happy endings. Many of the children that you're seeing on the screen as I speak are children who lost their battle with their illness either while they're at the village or shortly thereafter. But luckily for these families, they had the best week of their lives thanks to everything that you do. Everything that you do makes a tremendous difference in the lives of these families. It gives them precious memories that they can go back and reflect on and hopefully inspire them to continue that battle. But as you can see, these wonderful memories that are made, that they'll be able to look back at these pictures and be inspired by them and have some wonderful memories of other things than the doctor visits and the hospital calls. So I just want to take this opportunity to thank you from the bottom of my heart for the outpouring of love and support you give us day in and day out. I'd love to give each one of you a hug, so please stop by our booth and visit us and know from the bottom of our hearts we truly appreciate and look forward to the next 25 years of this amazing partnership. Thank you.
Doesn't it make you feel great to be a part of this industry? Oh, come on, doesn't that make you feel great to be a part of this industry? What a wonderful privilege to be able to partner with Give Kids the World. Next up in our show, our 2019 chairman will report back from his year of meeting members from around the world. I don't know about you, but I can't wait to hear what David Rosenberg is here to tell us. So ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the one and only David Rosenberg! He's the chairman, so we'll do it again. David Rosenberg! Okay, all right. It's like being in a circus again. All right. Well, folks, listen, my apologies.
Jonathan, I'm so sorry.
My goodness, David, good morning to you. Slow down, my friend.
Good morning.
We need you. You look really busy.
Well, it's been just as busy as the rest of the year. You know, it started just a couple hours ago at our new headquarters just down the street. Thank you.
were so tired. My goodness.
Well, let me tell you, a chairman's work is never done.
You really took that seriously, huh?
I sure did.
Well, do you have the energy to go on, David?
Always.
All right. David Rosenberg, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, still out of breath. I can't tell you how much I have loved meeting members this year, including right here in Orlando this week. I certainly tried to visit as many places as possible and as quickly as I could. I've already been asked, what was my favorite memory during my year as chair? It is hard to choose. I can go on and on about the amazing new global headquarters we opened right here in Orlando, the creative and energetic IAPA team that has been assembled, or being part of all the amazing actions the association took to protect and enhance the global attractions industry. And I'd say one of the big highlights for me was experiencing IAPA's main mission, to connect people and help those create inspiration. While I could easily speak about all the wonderful people I met, and of course their attractions, I wanted to narrow my focus today, mostly so I'm not up here for the next hour. I was excited to witness an industry-wide tidal wave, and it's all about the importance of embracing sustainability. We're becoming more aware how important it is for our guests, and therefore the success of our business, that we demonstrate a commitment to do things better. I saw this all over the world as I visited your facilities. And let me share just a couple of examples. In Mexico City, Miguel Quintana and the Xcaret team are inspiring visitors to learn the importance of protecting nature at their beautiful properties in the heart of the Mexican jungle. In China, I met the governor of Hainan and heard about the ambitious and visionary plans to make Hainan one of the greenest attraction zones in the entire country. And in Europe, Puy de Fou opened an amazing bird show that left us all in awe and reminds us why these creatures deserve our respect and, of course, our attention. And, of course, right here in North America, attractions like mine and many others are weaving sustainability into their fabric and, of course, as part of their visitor experience. And last but certainly not least, you probably heard about some big announcements from Disney, Six Flags, and other large theme park companies talking about their commitment to solar energy and plastic reduction. I was honored to serve on IAPA's first sustainability task force. This task force is made up of industry leaders from around the world, and they came together to create IAPA's first sustainability charter to make the association and all of us better stewards of our natural resources. Let's give that a round of applause. You know, reflecting back on some of my favorite childhood memories from my annual trips to Disneyland and San Diego Zoo, I think about how amazing it is that we're all in the business of creating memories that last a lifetime for the families that visit our attractions each and every day. Like you, I love what we do. I love this industry. I love that IAPA brings us all together to make us better. Thank you. Thank you so much for allowing me to serve as your chairman this year. It was a lot of work, but I'll tell you, it was an incredibly rewarding experience. I am forever grateful for the opportunity and appreciate your support that you provided me, our industry, and our amazing association over the last year. Thank you. I would also like to take a moment to acknowledge our outgoing board members. Their service was truly excellent, and we could not have had such a successful year without them. Thank you so much to the whole team. Now, my final presentation today is the IAPA Board of Directors Special Service Award. This special award is not an annual presentation, but is the one that the board selects to honor and recognize personal contributions to IAPA that go above and beyond. The board would like to recognize Charles Hank Salemi from Six Flags Great America in Gurnee, Illinois. Hank Hank has served on the IAAPA Board of Directors since 2009. He was elected treasurer of the Board of Directors in 2015, and he graciously agreed to two additional one-year extensions of his term as treasurer to see us through a number of important financial matters, including the relocation of our team from Alexandria to Orlando and the construction of the new global headquarters. He also chaired the CEO search committee in 2018. He was devoted to hundreds of hours to our association. When he's not sharing his strategic, straightforward insights with us, his day job is park president at Six Flags Great America, where he leads 5,000 full-time and seasonal team members across his 300-acre park. Hank has played an integral part in IAAPA's board of directors. Hank's passion, dedication, financial acumen, focus, and strategy has served IAAPA in countless ways. He has pushed us, he has challenged us, and he's helped to make all of us better. Please join me in congratulating the recipient of the IAAPA Board of Directors Special Service Award, Hank Salemi.
Thank you. Thank you so much, David. Wow, I am truly honored by this special recognition. I'm really thankful I didn't fall down walking up the stairs. That was my first goal this morning. But I am truly honored and thankful to work in this industry. We're so lucky that we get to go to work every day and make people happy. And it's so amazing that we have that opportunity, and I never take it for granted. Secondly, I am incredibly honored to work for the company that I work for. Six Flags has had an amazing run over the last decade, and I can unashamedly say I work for one of the best theme parks in the world. Six Flags Great America is an amazing park. If you've never come to visit us, please do. I've got a great team. Lastly, I am really, really honored to have served on the IAAPA board and as treasurer the last 5 years. It's been a heck of a road. I've made tremendous friends. I will tell you, this association is in tremendous hands when you talk about Hal McAvoy and his team of professionals that run this association. And I just wanted to say overall, thank you to this industry, thank you to this company, thank you to IAAPA, and thanks to my wife and daughter, Kathleen and Claire, for supporting me and being able to do this for the last 5 years. Thank you, everyone.
Let's hear it again for Hank, everyone. David, actually, could you come back on stage, please? That's right, we're having one of those moments. Come on over here, buddy. Now, my friend, the incoming chairman wanted to do something special for you. So I want you to listen to this voice and tell me if it sounds familiar.
Hey, David, do you remember earlier this year when our group went scuba diving at the Atlantis in Dubai? I was really glad to be there when you got to experience something with marine life. You know, fish.
Ted?
That's right. Let's hear it for Ted Malter from the San Diego Zoo. All right, let's keep it going. How about this voice?
Hey, David. Flying around the world must be quite an improvement from when you were a six-year-old. Our family drove across country. You were stuck in the back seat, getting hit in the head with your brother's guitar that he had to bring with him.
Yeah, that'd be my brother.
Everyone, let's welcome John Rosenberg. All right, okay, finally we have one more. I think this one is gonna be tough. How about this voice?
Hi there,
When our friends want to make plans and I say, we'd love to, but David will be in China or Russia or Paris or Finland or Dubai, do you think they're envious or just annoyed? Let's celebrate a great year and open up that treasured bottle of 92 Silver Oak. Cheers.
That's my wife.
Oh, all right. Ooh, if you would have messed that one up. Yeah. All right, everybody, let's welcome the lovely Mrs. Rosenberg.
You bring it with you?
The best part about that, I think every married man in here was like, I think that's my wife. And finally, there's one more person who wants to say hello to you. Please welcome your incoming IAPA chairman, Amanda Thompson.
David, this has truly been your year. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Everyone, let's hear it for our wonderful David Rosenberg. All right, and now the new chapter begins. How about it? She is Amanda Thompson. I love the outfit. You look
fabulous. I'm bending into the chair, Jonathan.
In the sneakers. That's the beauty of it. You are an artist. And you come from such a legendary family, four generations in the attraction industry, starting back in 1896. You have three generations of managing directors of the iconic Blackpool Pleasure Beach. You're one of the managing directors, and of course, two generations of chairmen of IAPA. How has all of that experience, all of that history, informed you?
Well, you can't get away from it because you're brought up in it. But IAPA has been part of my life for many, many years. I think I first exhibited here when I was about 22, so I'm not saying how long ago that was, but it was a while ago. And I can honestly say that having a great-grandfather that trudged across the ocean in 1923 to deliver a speech at IAPA is quite an amazing thing to have achieved. I had no idea of this, and Jim Fritchell told me the amazing story just about 2 weeks ago. So that was truly an honor to hear that story.
That's so wonderful. Now, speaking of growing up in this, I love the wonderful story I read about you being 7 years old and your grandfather, Leonard, who put the I in IAPA, by the way, our first international member. He comes to you and you say, like most little girls, I want a pony. And he says to you, get to work.
Well, he did, but it wasn't I want a pony, it was my birthday.
Okay.
And he did say no. And he did say, absolutely not, you can't have one. But he said, but maybe if you can look after one and work for one, maybe there's a chance. So at the time, we had a pony ride at the park. So I worked there for what I believed to be the whole of my summer holiday. But probably, in reality, it was probably about 2 weeks. And I was about 7 years old, and I learned how to muck out, how to look after the ponies. And I did all of that. And at the end of it, it was my birthday. And so he said to me, choose which one you want. Much to Mummy's horror, the pony came home.
That is wonderful. Now, you also are a producer and director of some fantastic productions. One of them, of course, is close to my heart, Eclipse, which is circus. You're award-winning. How does your production skills, your directional skills, your artistic acumen inform your work as a leader?
Well, I think because you're in charge, well, when I began producing shows, I was about 19. So I was in charge of lots of people at a very early age. And I was given the responsibility of producing ice shows in our park in Myrtle Beach. And so that was my first challenge. And I'm not sure Myrtle Beach was quite ready for the type of show that I was going to do. But anyway, they learnt to live with it, I'd say. But I think it was a little shocking at the beginning. But I've now been lucky enough to work all over the world in the entertainment industry. And I've worked with literally thousands of entertainers from all forms of the world that we love and work in. But I can honestly say circus was very special to me. But I think most people would know me for magic shows or ice skating or something like that. But circus was, for me, a real honor and a privilege to work in, because it's hard to be involved and embraced by that world, but I truly was, and I was awarded many accolades for Eclipse, and I was very lucky.
Wonderful. Well, let's talk about your upcoming role in IAPA. Can you tell us anything about your plans for the year?
Well, I've got lots of plans for the year, but I have to be very calm and cool and collected about it all. But I think the most important thing is to remember that all of you here, the members, are the most important part of IAPA. IAPA is a member-driven association, and please tell us what you need. I'm going to make a difference. I'm going to try and listen to as many people as I possibly can and make the difference for you all in the coming years, because I really do believe that we have a great future. We're a global industry, and we truly are global, and I think that we've got to remember that, and we've got to reach out to all corners of the globe. And I'm going to work hard to include all the manufacturers as well and see as many of you as possible. This isn't a holiday for me. This is truly work. But I'm going to dip in and out of IAPA, but I'm going to do the best I can for all of you members. So it really is important that you tell me what you'd like from IAPA, and we'll deliver that back to you.
Wonderful. Now, Amanda, I believe you had a few more things you wanted to share with us before we wrap up.
Yes, I believe I do. Yes, I'd like to thank our directors who are remaining on the board for 2020. You've done a really superb job in the past, and I know that you'll do a great job in the future. And they'll be joined by our new incoming 2020 board members. I'd like to thank you all for giving up your time and serving with us, and I'm really, really looking forward to working with you all. Thank you. And finally, I'd like to introduce our new 2020 officers.
Ladies and gentlemen, please, a round of applause for our chairman, Amanda Thompson.
Thank you. Thank you.
Exciting. The new board members we just showed you up on those screens will bring fresh ideas to the association. And the new attractions you're about to see will certainly inspire you to think different about your attractions back home. So take a look.
Jure Summerland opened Tyrion, a gyro swing that whisks guests up to 45 meters in the air. Sesame Street Street Mission at PortAventura World is a mixed media attraction where players can help Detective Grover complete a secret mission. Fantasylandia's new superhero is a rotating wheel that sends guests flying in the prone position more than 20 meters high at speeds of 50 kilometers per hour. Reese's Cup Fusion is a sweet full sensory adventure at Hershey Park, where guests become agents to protect the factory. And Universal's Islands of Adventure open Hagrid's Magical Creatures Motorbike Adventure with ride vehicles designed to look like Hagrid's iconic motorcycle and sidecar. We continue with new water rides. King Cobra at Hurricane Harbor Wastapec sends riders through high-speed turns with a final drop of 7 meters. Island H2O Live is a brand new digitally connected water park with rides like Hashtag Heights, Profile Plunge, and Reply Racers. Family Twister at Escape Theme Park is now the world's longest water slide, clocking in at 4 minutes. And Skara Summerland's Waka Waka is the first water slide of its kind in Europe. It's just like skiing, where riders get a speed boost at every turn. Next up, brand new parks open to guests all over the world. Vananava Water Jungle opened in Nong Khae, Thailand, and is the first ecologically aware community water park in the region. Lionsgate Entertainment World is Asia's first movie-themed vertical indoor entertainment experience. Savage is a thrilling new park that sends guests kayaking down the only canals in Cancun. There's also whitewater rafting, jet boat adventures, and more. 9.81 Park features environmentally friendly racing that uses gravity for power and speed. Haicheng Ocean Park opened in Shanghai and features lava drifting, the new water ride from whitewater. National Geographic Ultimate Explorer is the first augmented reality park in Latin America. Guests can visit space or dive into the depths of the ocean using special viewfinders. Grupo Vidanta's luxury boutique water park, Jungala, is an immersive and exclusive entertainment experience for guests craving glamorous adventures. Perfect Day at Coco Cay is a new water park in the Bahamas, accessible only by Royal Caribbean Cruise Line passengers seeking thrill and chill. Xehuyup in Guatemala combines the beauty of the natural with the magic of attractions and imaginative games. Guests can even stay on property at the new hostel, Aldea de la Selva, in treehouses, tents, and carts by the river, or beautiful cabins and huts. Ventura Fly and Ride Park in the Mexican Caribbean hosts 8 unique aerial attractions, plus guests can test their driving skills in 3 types of vehicles. Play Center Family combines the Playlands concept with the amusement park experience. E-Magic Park pairs Pure Family Entertainment with the latest technology, featuring special activities designed to motivate guests' creativity and develop their skills. And Aquafan Aventura features an extreme zipline, freefall, aerial circuits, a climbing wall, and more. Every year, coasters hit greater heights, reach faster speeds, and feature more twists and turns. Fantawild Oriental Heritage Theme Park's Hyperspace Warp provides a mix of airtime hills, inversions, and 2 underground tunnels. Taiga at Linamaki reaches heights of 52 meters. It's so tall it can be seen from across the city of Helsinki. Untamed at Walibi Holland is the first hybrid coaster in Europe, boasting 5 inversions, including a one-of-a-kind 270-degree stall. Tidal Twister at SeaWorld San Diego is a dueling coaster, sending guests forward and backward on opposite ends of a stretch train over a figure-eight track. Kennywood Steel Curtain races through 9 inversions, a 197-foot tall loop, and 4,000 feet of track at 75 miles per hour. Tigress at Busch Gardens Tampa Bay catapults riders through an exhilarating inversion, then travels forward and backward while navigating numerous twists. Carowinds Copperhead Strike launches riders from 0 to 42 miles per hour in just 2.5 seconds. Yukon Striker at Canada's Wonderland is an epic journey that begins high above the park's skyline and makes a complete 360-degree loop. And Dueling Dragons at Guangzhou Scenic Land is a triple LSM launch coaster featuring 2 trains that duel each other, reaching top speeds of 110 kilometers. Now here's some of what's new in animal habitats this year. Dolphin Cove Puerto Seco's new habitat in Jamaica is surrounded by crystal clear water beaches and hosts 4 bottlenose dolphins. These animals will be protected by the highest standards of Grupo Dolphin Discovery. The Milwaukee County Zoo's massive new 20,000 square foot elephant exhibit features a recreation room, 5 individual stalls for training and husbandry, and expansive space for enrichment activities. Extensive ride remodels and new lands also made big news this year. Guests can take a stroll down Sesame Street at the brand new Sesame Street Land in SeaWorld Orlando, where they'll also find Hooper's Store and Big Bird's Nest. Wildwood Grove at Dollywood is the largest expansion in the park's history. It includes the Dragonflyer Coaster, the Wildwood Tree Show, and so much more. Universal Studios Hollywood opened the new Jurassic World The Ride, featuring immersive digital film sequences and a thrilling flume ride with steep drops. and guests can live their own Star Wars story inside the immersive Star Wars Galaxy's Edge at both Disneyland and Disney's Hollywood Studios. Guests can fly the Millennium Falcon, interact with their favorite characters, hand-build their own lightsabers, and so much more.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. How about that? Now, we recap the year. You met new IAPA Hall of Fame members. You heard from your board chairman. Now, as I bid you farewell, it's almost time to open the expo floor. Thank you all for joining us, and we hope you have a wonderful week at IAPA Expo 2019! Is now open.